The one-shot sticky bomb meta is back, and it is lame.
In this video, I'm going to give you a few quick tips for how to counter this, because this is not fun for anyone. Stick around.
What's up, guys? It's Skill Up here with another Division video. Many people have been asking me to do a one-shot sticky bomb build guide, and to that I say, no way in hell. I'm not remotely interested in promoting this style of play because I think it's extremely lame. It's the exact same reason that I never did a one-shot headshot shotgun build, even though I know that's what everyone was running. These sorts of patterns of play are ultimately bad for the game because they just piss people off, so I don't know why people would want to promote this style of play. I personally am interested in helping you counter this style of play. So in this video, I'm going to give you a few quick tips to be able to deal with this rubbish, so hopefully you can actually have some fun in the Dark Zone rather than just walking around getting one shot all of a sudden. Alright, so let's spend a moment understanding how this build works so that we really understand how to counter it. The one shot sticky bomb is back essentially because 256 gear has more stats on it, allowing us to move further up the skill power curve, getting to that point where the sticky bomb becomes lethal. The thing is, our health does not scale in the same way that skill power does, and in particular, the fact is most of us are not running exotic damage resilience these days. We're just stacking health and armor, making us completely susceptible to the kind of damage that the sticky bomb does. Now, as I said, I'm not going to give you a build guide for this, but you can use your own brain and figure out that if you stack lots and lots of skill power and then fire a sticky bomb at someone, they are going to die. Any more detail than that, you're going to have to go find it somewhere else. But critically for those playing against it, it's important to understand that most of these people who are running this build are probably having to sacrifice a fair amount of toughness in order to be able to do it. In particular, they need to keep their stamina and their firearms quite low. They may be sacrificing some of their armor rolls on their, say for instance, backpack in order to stack additional skill power. There's a variety of trade-offs that these people might need to make in order to get to this point. So for that reason, they can be quite squishy. One of the best pieces of advice that I can give you when you're going up against a sticky bomb is actually just to shoot the person in the face. You'll find very often that they'll drop quite quickly if you can get the jump on them. Most people running these sticky bomb builds are probably going to be stacking around 250 to around 290 base skill power. They're probably going to be wearing tacticians, so if they're running in a four-man group, they're going to have a lot more than that. But 250-260k is about the point where they're going to be able to one-shot you if you're in a standard build. The two people here that I'm using for this demonstration are both wearing zero exotic damage resilience, and they have about 170 or 180k HP. That's usually brings them to around 400k toughness all in. Not that armor does anything in this equation. And you'll notice that with my build at 250,000 skill power, as well as about 16% bonus damage from mods, I'm able to do about 160k damage to these guys, bringing them within an inch of their life. Now, do remember this footage, because this is the footage that we'll continue to use as the baseline for the rest of the demonstration, showing you all the ways you can counter this and how much damage it actually reduces. By far and away, the easiest way to counter this playstyle is to wear two-piece final measure. You'll notice that this actually gives you a bonus 25% exotic damage resilience, which does make a significant difference. Here in this footage, you'll see the target on the left is now wearing the two-piece final measure versus the target on the right who is not. You'll see when I fire at them and I detonate the sticky bomb, the target on the left has significantly more health left over, allowing them to do all sorts of things like heal and medkit and shoot me back in the face while my sticky bomb is on cooldown, given that I'm a bit of a one-trick pony. Here now, let's talk about the ballistic shield. Now, many of you will know that the new defense gear set allows you to use your SMG while using a shield. It's a very strong build in PvP, and it's very strong against the sticky bomb because look at this. Boom. When you fire the sticky bomb, if you have your shield up, it actually does no damage. Target on the left, no damage taken. Target on the right, full damage taken. The shield is a barrier. It completely blocks all ballistic shield damage. And it's also just a damn good set as well. So whip out that set, give it a go if you're finding these sticky bombs being problematic. The other thing I'll say is that it does provide line of sight to other party members. You'll notice here that the other person is now lining up directly behind the ballistic shield. I'm firing in front of it. The person behind is taking no damage whatsoever, even though they're in the blast radius. The ballistic shield does provide a full line of sight block, so keep that in mind. If one of your team members is running with the ballistic shield,
shield, you can use them to fully block the damage. So that's gear and the ballistic shield. Let's very quickly talk about talents right now and how you can mitigate some of the talent selections these players are making. So these guys are probably going to be running a talent called Chain Reaction, which basically increases the damage that their sticky bomb deals for every additional target that they hit. Now, the people that you're seeing in front of me here, I can't kill them with my current sticky bomb build, but if I use Chain Reaction, I'm dealing an extra 20% damage when I hit both of them. I'm able to kill them with ease. So my very strong tip here is when you are going up against sticky bomb players, make sure you are spread out. You do not want that Chain Reaction talent proccing, amplifying the damage dealt by that sticky bomb by a significant amount. Next up, let's talk Smart Cover, an ability that we used to use all the time in patch 1.3, but has definitely fallen by the wayside. Smart Cover has base damage resistance baked into it, and it scales up the more skill power you are stacking. Your average player who's running anywhere between about 80 to 110 skill power is probably going to get about 15% total damage resistance out of that ability, making it quite useful in the context of the one-shot sticky bomb meta. Here you'll see the two people lined up against each other, both with exactly the same gear, one of them protected by Smart Cover and the other not. You'll see the Smart Cover person survives where the other person does not. So if worst comes to worst and you can afford it, whip out your Smart Cover once again. It will save your life. One that you may not be aware of is that your heal, and specifically the booster shot mod of that heal, actually gives you 25% damage resistance as soon as you pop it. Most people just use this as a damage boost, but it is also simultaneously making you much more tanky. Here, the target on the left is about to pop their heal the moment before I detonate, and you'll see they take significantly less damage than the other target. So if you can time it, if you hear that sticky bomb go out and you know it's going to hit you, maybe you want to drop your booster shot heal before the detonation rather than after, as it will save you a lot of damage. You can then pop a med kit with, say, for instance, critical save, which increases your damage resistance by 40%. You're going to be all healed up, or fairly healed up, and quite tanky as you do that. The very last tip is a little bit unrealistic, but I'm going to mention it anyway. You can actually flashbang someone else's sticky bomb and actually sort of, you know, stop it from detonating. The flashbang serves as a bit of an EMP. It short circuits any skills that are active, including sticky bombs. So if you can time it and you can somehow like get this down in between the time when they send it out and they detonate it, then sure, you can absolutely save yourself. But realistically, I think the chances of that are pretty slim. You'll need some pretty damn good reflexes for that. Anyway, guys, that's it for this video. I really, really hope that Massive addresses this ASAP. Having been in the Dark Zone a little bit in patch 1.5, I've tried to spend a bit of time there. I can tell you that this is not fun to play against. I would encourage people to not play it. But if you're encountering other players that are doing it, I hope these tips do help you out. Let me know in the comments below if you have any other suggestions yourself, and I'll try and add them to the description as well. Really want to make sure people are having as good a time as possible in the Dark Zone, because it can already be quite a punishing environment as it is without having one-shot sticky bombs wrecking everyone's day. Guys, if you liked this video and you found it useful, do drop it a like, and obviously you can subscribe to my channel for lots and lots of Division coverage. I'm going to be doing two more videos this week. I've got one coming up tomorrow night on a gear set. I've got one coming up on Tuesday night specifically for PS4 players on how they can make the most of patch 1.5, and then I'm doing my State of the Game stuff on Thursday night / Friday morning. After that, I'm on vacation. I'm looking forward to that. So yeah. Anyway, guys, take good care, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.